subscribe, and hit the bell icon and never miss another video.
ये सर नॉर्मली फिल्मों में इंडस्ट्रियों का खुलासा करते हैं, मुझे मैं इनके बारे में क्या सोचती हूँ उसका खुलासा करना पड़ेगा. ह्यूमर हैज बीन सच अ मेल इमोशन, राइट? इट्स नॉट समथिंग दैट वी सी, यू डोंट ऑफन सी विमेन प्लेइंग. आई वाज लाइक अ दादा इन स्कूल, सो आई रियली गॉट माय चांस टू चैनल माय एंडोजिनस सेल्फ very very well in a character like Bubbly.
There is a humorous side in me, though I make serious cinema, and I just felt it ki I treated her like a newcomer. I said teri ek relaunch hai tera yahan pe picture mein.
Yeah, because I was opening doors for people. That's when I know that Bubbly has kind of gotten a bit too deep into me. But I was essentially a tomboy when I was in school.
Hey guys, this is Nawaz Kochra from Team Miss Malini, and I am here with a very amazing team of Bubbly Bouncer. We have with us the man behind the magic, Madhur Bhandarkar, and who doesn't know Bubbly Tanwar? She's funny, she's very very funny, and that is Tamanna Bhatia for us. Hello guys, welcome to Miss Malini, how are you?
Thank you, it's always such a pleasure interacting with Team Miss Malini, because I think it's some of the most fun content that's there on social media, so I love following her and seeing what she does.
And you know, while you love following Miss Malini, I absolutely loved watching Bubbly Bouncer because of so many reasons that it was different in so many manners. Like I don't think so for a very long time I have been immersed in a film so much. And that was first of all because of the amazing performances. But what I also liked was that this film had a reverse narrative. Like, you know, usually hum movies mein dekhte hain ladke ko ladki pasand aayi, he is trying to impress her, but here it was ulta, and that was so beautiful about it. But I want to know, for the first time, Tamanna, when you received that call from Madhur sir that, you know, he wants you to work in this film, what was your reaction?
ये सर नॉर्मली फिल्मों में इंडस्ट्रियों का खुलासा करते हैं, मुझे मैं इनके बारे में क्या सोचती हूँ उसका खुलासा करना पड़ेगा.
What was the reaction there? I also want to know.
I was definitely like jumping. There's no other reaction that there can be to work with Madhur sir. As everyone knows, I mean, he's only given all the actresses that have worked with him, it's their career best. There's just no debate on that. I think he always chooses parts that are extremely well written. So I think even his judgment in terms of when he's representing a world, it's the writing also that he's so focused on. So I know that even during Bubbly, I think for 2 years,
were you guys on the script? 18 and 19.
You know, I think that involvement as a director is not just from, it's just not once the script is ready, but from the script level itself, he's so involved. Right. So I think that really mattered to me. But I was very happy when I heard the script because it was nothing like what he normally does. It was a completely different world in the sense that it was humor based, and humor has been such a male emotion, right? It's not something that we see, we don't often see women playing innately humorous characters, or just, it's far and few, you know. So also physical strength, I think we haven't seen a lot of women being presented. Absolutely. from the fact that they're not just emotionally strong, but they're also physically strong. I also feel like this film in general broke a lot of cliches because the character itself is really gender neutral, because she's really feminine in parts, because she's really cute and like, just like her name suggests, bubbly in some way. And she's, you know, she's quite tough and, you know, has a really strong sense of self, and she can really beat up bad people if the occasion calls for it. So I think I also as an actor got to channel something that was very personal to me, which was, I was like a dada in school. So I really got my chance to channel my androgynous self very, very well in a character like Bubbly.
Also, you know, Madhur sir, so what I also liked about Bubbly Bouncer is that it's a very sweet slice of life movie, contrary to, very different to, you know, what we've seen the Madhur Bhandarkar space to be. So, you know, what was that, like, was it a conscious effort to, you know, bring out or, you know, say a story which was so different, slice of life? And also, you know, what was it like, at what point did you see Bubbly in Tamanna?
See, one thing is that people who know closely to me, they know that I have a wacky sense of humor. I laugh on myself also. I keep mimicking people all the time. So there is a humorous side in me, though I make serious cinema. In fact, Tabu after Chandni Bar, while shooting only, she should tell me, Madhur, you please make a comedy film. Yeah? Behind the scene is a laugh riot. So, you know, so those were the things always there. But Bubbly Bouncer, it was a deliberate attempt to make a film light-hearted, slice of life, and to present Bubbly in a very comical way, and, you know, family. As for Tamanna, when I met her, she loved the script and I narrated her. And I just felt it, I treated her like a newcomer. I said, "Teri relaunch hai tera yahan pe picture mein." And she completely surrendered to the vision of the writing and the filmmaker. And I'm very happy for her, especially because the kind of applause she's getting, the kind of love she's getting, she's conquering hearts everywhere.
But what's been the best compliment received so far?
See, best compliment is from everywhere, I mean to say. Your best compliment receiving everywhere, like a lot of people are saying, ye itne saal se Tamanna Bhatia thi ka. Ye talent ko kisne itne time se kyun nahi chuna? But I'm happy I'm the one person.
No, so I mean that is such an achievement for me.
I can take the credit, na?
100%. Listen, it is the truth. And also I feel like I've seen this in few filmmakers, and I think Madhurso is one of them, is he's never casted anybody, even if they're already leading actresses, already doing really well, he never casts them because of a market they have.
Exactly.
But because they actually suit the part.
The character.
And I think today the time is such that I don't think films can be made also like that. I think how much ever you might have a market in any place, I feel like essentially you need to suit the bill, whatever that character is. And I'm glad that Madhur sir had not seen any of my work. And I think Bahubali, he had seen, but he didn't remember much of it. So I was happy. Like, if for me also as an actor, it was like working on a clean slate and kind of unlearning everything that I've known till now and kind of working afresh. And working with him has yielded to my best performance till date, primarily because he let me bloom. You know, he never puppeted me to a point where I felt like, you know, I couldn't function. He in fact let me, you know, he had faith in me. And I think that's something I learned from him while working on Bubbly. Not just me, but everybody who was in the team. He's such a happy-go-lucky person on set. He doesn't create a stressful environment, which makes everybody want to give him his best. You know, so.
But you know, also meeting him for the first time probably is that sense of nervousness that, oh my god, I'm meeting Madhur Bhandari.
Yeah, but I think it cracks in like five minutes. He's too warm for you to, you know, feel intimidated, which is, I think, he's a Padma Shri 4-time National Award winning director, but I think his vibe is so, he's so youthful, he's just so light at heart, and I think he's just so welcoming and warm. I think that is something that, that I think everybody who's met him will unanimously say that.
Also, you know, I want to know that during, like, while preparing for this character, obviously physical training is a lot, I'm sure. But was there probably a point where you felt that Tamanna has now become Bubbly?
Yeah, because I was opening doors for people. That's when I know that Bubbly has kind of gotten a bit too deep into me. Yeah, I actually was opening doors.
Yeah, you told me the hangover
was there. Oh my God.
It was so funny. I was like, it's nice if a girl opens the door for a guy, but I started opening door for men and I was like, what am I doing? I was like, oh, because that bouncer thing was not going out of me. Which is great. I think I should still keep opening doors. That's not a bad thing.
But it's out of your system now, or does it take some time?
See, the thing is, not many people know, but I was essentially a tomboy when I was in school. So what I have channeled people like, oh, this body language is, who is this person? You know, we've never seen this before, all that. It's always been there in me. It just never got channeled because I did a lot of very strongly feminine characters. So I never got a chance to channel it. Maybe maybe a little bit of it in Avantika, like in Bahubali, because I had to fight and stuff.
Correct.
But I think this really got the very authentic, Masti Khor side of me out.
There are 6 amazing projects coming up after this.
It's quite a ride. I have lots.
And lots going on. Both of y'all have been in this industry for such a long time, like close to 3 decades, close to 2 decades, if I'm not wrong. And is there one evident change in this industry that y'all have seen and y'all probably absolutely love it?
Well, I think definitely more organized now. When I started, it was single producer is to be the producers, or 2-3 producers is to be. But now, since corporates have come, so definitely there's a major changeover, and well organized. And I think, and the one thing which I like about a lot of corporates when have come, all this on the OTT also, they give breaks to newcomers. I mean, for our time, very difficult when we started. There are scripts which they want to make and they're pushing the envelope. That's the great change. Actors want to shed their image. They don't want to get into a particular image. That's the great thing again. They want to do a challenging role. So these are the things which, and trust me, I'm telling you now, every 5 years there's a major revamp in the industry. And it has happened. In between, we went on a pause mode since because of the pandemic. But if you see, before that also, when I used to say the OTT platform and the film industry were coexisting together, right, and both were doing very well. Okay, post-pandemic, now things are again getting normalized. Things are on the back on the track. Film theater also doing very well. OTT is also very well. So I think now actors are definitely want to do more roles. They can definitely, if they don't feel that this movie is not for theater, they are doing it for OTT. They're doing web series, big web series, and huge budgets are there, enormous budgets are there. I think those are the major changes in last 5 years we have seen. I seen the industry, when I said it started from single producer used to be there.
Yes. And from the Rangila days.
From the Rangila days. Yeah, I've been associate director, then I made my debut film, you know how it was. So things have really changed. I've seen very in close quarters. So I think that today is a great time for especially filmmakers who have innovative ideas, who want to say something different subject. That's a great platform today.
Absolutely.
And what is that evident change that probably you witnessed as an actor in this industry over these years?
Apart from all the absolutely accurate things he said, I think the writing has changed a lot.
Yes.
For me, that is a very big thing because as a female actor, I remember parts that were written before were very superficial. There wasn't much to do. Also, they weren't really plot related, so it was really like, you know, there's not much scope as an actor. But today I think, like Sir said, people are willing to explore different areas and because content is being consumed in so many different platforms, the value of a writer has now finally come into the forefront.
Wow. Also, sir, you know, if there has to be one project, I know it's, you know, always asking somebody to choose from your children, but you know, if there is one project that is extremely close to your heart, Kuch Bhi Ho Jaye, that project is always going to be close to Madhur Bhandarkar. What would that be?
In my filmography?
Yes, yes.
One film which is close to my heart. See, for me, every film is my child. Yeah, I cannot differentiate between the all the other films. Every film I made only.
Yes.
Some may be very successful, some may be average successful. But they're all projects very difficult to find, yeah. I think very honestly, my first project, Three Shakti, which didn't do well at the box office, it was a big flop. That really gave me basically the thing about, I saw the industry in very close quarters. Okay, how people, it gave me a lesson. Sometimes there's a saying in English, failure is the first step to success.
Yeah.
So I think that really gave me this edge. You know, the first film was bombed suddenly. I didn't know where to go. Nobody used to pick up my phone. Nobody used to answer. You know, as if I was not famous. I was just a filmmaker who just came. So that gave me a strong perspective of the film industry. From that day, I very detached myself from the glamour world, I mean to say. I never got carried away with the, in 21 years of my career, very honestly, very brutally honestly, I'll say, I never had Mad Fridays in my life. I never have chamchas. I never belonged to any camp. It's my journey as an individual director. I made it on my own. Whatever the audience has given me love, whatever my Padma Shri, my national award, my international fame, everything, whatever I got, and the commercial success, it is because of the audience.
So
the first movie has really taught me about it. So Three Shakti was definitely a stepping stone for me to success. So that movie will definitely be there in my filmography. Whenever you repeat all my films, it's a cult film. But Three Shakti was a film which gave me the point of view, the ringside view of the film industry.
Also, last one coming your way, Tamanna. Has there been a dream role in all these years? And, you know, have you played it or is it yet to come?
I think, you know, that's a hole that is, you're never going to be able to fill that hole. It's going to constantly go deeper and deeper. I think with Bubbly, definitely my attempt to do something that showcased me in a very authentic light was something I definitely achieved with Bubbly.
Wow.
But yes, I do want to do an out-and-out action film, which is, actually female-led, because we don't have any action films for women. And hopefully a dance movie. Like, I've always wanted to be a part of a dance film, because I love dancing, but I don't dance as much as I would like to. So I know if it comes onto a movie, I would completely metamorphosize and then get into dance mode.
Sure. I just personally intervene in between. I think,
yes.
I just...
Yeah, of course.
I think Tamanna with Bubbly Bonsor as an actress, she's arrived. And I feel she has tremendous potential as an actress. And I feel, you know, why I was making also the film, I think half the film I told, I said, Tamanna, you have to do varied role. Remember, yeah. I used to tell in Chandigarh also. We were just doing the film. I said, you have good talent, good potential, but you have to do very different kind of role. I think, jaise kehta na, ye, she's arrived. Deir hai, durust hai. So she's arrived now. I think it's just a beginning for her. Bubbly Bouncer is completely
it's kind
beginning
of a
for
new,
her.
It's kind of a restart. Yeah.
Restart for
so.
Her. So she has tremendous talent. And I'm sure after watching Bubbly Bouncer, I know so many filmmakers have called me and like, you know, they appreciated her. Ki she chooses the right script and the right, obviously, filmmaker. And the right way she can definitely do some different kind of cinema. And she should do all kind of cinema.
Yes.
It is not only comedy she should do. She should do action film also. She should do serious movie also. She should do a commercial film also.
Yeah.
Every kind of film she should do. Because I think she has a lot of potential.
I think I'm taking my notes.
Absolutely. Well, I just hope and wish that it is upwards and onwards from here on for both of y'all.
Thank you.
We get to see lots and lots of amazing work coming in the future.
Thank you.
Also, super excited and thank you so much for removing time and doing this.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
for
so
having
much,
us
yeah.
here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.